You know, I can't even wait until halftime to make a video on this situation. I can't even wait until halftime. What are y'all doing out there? What are you doing? This is one of the worst teams in the SEC. And you're losing 10-7 right now? Really? Joseph Charlton, for all he's done for South Carolina, I mean, I can't say anything bad about the kid, you know? I mean, he's on the field about 12 times a game this year because our offense can't move the freaking ball. You've already got one tailback injured, all right? He comes back in for one play, runs for 2 yards and nothing. And then what do? You punt the ball straight to him and he runs it up 65 yards for a touchdown. If it wasn't for this freaking 75-yard freak play on the first play of the damn game, you'd be behind right now 10-0. This is sad. It's pathetic. It is pathetic. You're letting them hit these receivers after you bottle them up, you stuff them, first down, second down, you stuff them, and then you're letting them hit these receivers, just run at will. It's absolutely pathetic. This secondary is playing this garbage, sissy ass, soft defense. What are you doing? What are you doing? Ryan Helinski, what are you doing? Coach Boone. Where's the carry-on Joyner? Did he miss the bus? Did he miss the plane? Is he missing? Did somebody abduct him? Is his picture on the back of a buttermilk carton? Because if it's not, he needs to get in there. We need some kind of spark. His team is playing like shit. If they lose this game to this sorry-ass team, I don't know what I'm going to do when we're done. I don't know what I'm going to do. I'm ill. You know, Georgia got behind Tennessee early on in that game, but they knew it was going to be all right. We got behind them right now. I don't know that it's going to be all right because it is looking really, really bad. This offense is the worst I have seen in years, point blank. God, Monty. What's up, guys? Carolina Jackpot coming at you. 11 minutes, 47 seconds left in the South Carolina versus Tennessee game. Right now, my crappy Gamecocks are behind 34-21 to the equally crappy Tennessee Volunteers on the road and in the fourth quarter. It ain't looking good. And hey, we just got a punt blocked. And Tennessee returns it for a touchdown. And guess what? Daniel Batuli! Mr. Batuli! La 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 la! Woo! Yay, 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 yay! Cha cha cha. I'm gonna stop before I say something I shouldn't. So, South Carolina is now behind by 20 to one of the worst teams in the Southeastern Conference. Well, I guess they're not one of the worst teams in the Southeastern Conference. We're behind them now by 20 points. And, we're behind them by almost as much as they beat Chattanooga by, which is one of their two wins this year. I mean, this is embarrassing. And God damn it, I'm not afraid to cuss here. I expected this game to be a blowout. I thought it was going to be one-sided and a blowout. I expected it to be one-sided and a blowout on our side. You know, I expected this to go much like the Kentucky game did, which a lot of people thought that game was going to be close. We didn't let it be close. I thought it was going to be like last year's Vanderbilt game was, which was going to be close. We blew them out, and it wasn't close. This is abysmal, pathetic, and sad. For what it's worth, I would give a shout-out and credit to Marquez Callaway and Juwan Jennings. They've been there at the UT program, been wide receivers, and they've stuck with them for years through the Butch Jones bullshit. and through everything. And they're having a damn field day today against a defense that Jeremy Pruitt and his staff have picked out something on South Carolina's defense in the secondary that they like, and they've been picking on it today that other teams haven't picked on. And credit them for doing that. Goddamn, I'm irate, but I'm trying to hold it in right now because this is kind of, you know, where when your team is losing and you know that you have a chance to come back. So you're like really irate, like Uncle Lou gets in these videos sometimes. It's kind of past me now because I know we don't have a chance to come back. We are down by 20 points. We're down by 20 points to the Tennessee Volunteers. We're not down by 20 points to Peyton Manning's Tennessee Volunteers. We're down by 20 points to Jeremy Pruitt's Tennessee Volunteers. That's terrible. That's sad. I want to chalk it up to something, and you know what I would like to chalk it up to is I don't know. This is just their day. I mean, these guys have been with this program for years, and they're finally having a breakout game against a defense that's playing soft. I mean, and let's just face it, they're playing like a bunch of pussies. I mean, they are. They are playing like a bunch of walking vaginas with helmets on. 41-21, really, to Tennessee. This is abysmal and shitty. And this is why I talk about I question my fanhood sometimes, because, I mean, South Carolina has had a penchant in the past for years for making quarterbacks that just absolutely suck balls look like Joe Montana. I mean, they really have. Ryan Finley with North Carolina State, I mean, they, you know, even though we won that game, they have made I don't know who. Cole Stout at Clemson, I mean, they've just made some really bad quarterbacks look good, and we're doing it again. It's not just the Muschamp thing. It's a South Carolina thing. It's just a program thing. I'm just angry. I'm angry at this. I'm angry at the effort out there today. Who is that? Who's number 15? Why is this son of a bitch keep batting the damn ball down? This shitty, mediocre, damn defensive end. He's batted like four balls down. Someone just grab his arms and hold him down. They've been holding you the whole game. I said I wasn't going to get upset, didn't I? Bottom line, Tennessee is not a good team. They're not a good team. They're a shitty team. They suck. And guess what's even worse than that? We suck even worse than them. Ryan Helinski, I love him. I love his story. I love everything about him. I love the three in the air. I love all this. I love all the everything he's brought to the University of South Carolina. But you know what? I mean, if he's not the best player to be out here right now, let's coach him up a little bit. Who's this? His last name said Totem Pole on the back of his jersey. I swear to God. Last name said Totem Pole. First name Totem, last name Pole. If he's not the best kid to be out there right now, let's play the best kid. Where's the carry on Joyner been at today? We could have used Bentley. Yeah, we could have. And I did that last week after the loss to Florida. You know, as much as we besmirched, we bitched and bemoaned Jake Bentley, and there were so many damn shitty fans out there who, glad after we lost to North Carolina, they said, oh, thank God he's gone. He kicked a locker and broke his foot. So he don't get to play no more. Now we got these freshmen in here, and he's going to set the world on fire. And guess what? He set the world on fire against Charleston Southern. We played Alabama. He set the world on fire against Alabama. He didn't win, but he set the world on fire. We played Missouri. We'll forget that one. We played Kentucky. Well, we'll forget that. He didn't play much. I mean, yeah. Hound Dog said, go Vols. Thanks for the great game. Thanks for the first half. Yeah, it's been, what's it been, like 15 years since y'all blown somebody out? You might well be damn thankful for it. You might be well thankful for our shitty team. I'm going to tell you one thing right now. Your seniors that played good today, they deserve this. But mark my words, I'm going to tell you something else. You're not a good football team. You're a shitty football team. I mean, and that's just facts. You are, and you know it. You're a shitty football team. But on this day, our shitty football team was just a little bit shittier. And you actually rose to the occasion. Oh, but we played Alabama close. Go to hell. I am just... I still have hope 6 wins are within reach. Are you smoking crack? I can't remember who said that. Are you smoking crack? You think we're going to beat Appalachian State in a few weeks? I mean, I thought it was a joke, too, a couple weeks ago. We ain't going to beat App State. I mean, we can't even hold this shitty-ass damn offense out of the damn end zone. What makes you think we're going to be able to hold a viable end zone? A viable offense out of the end zone. We're not. They're going to damn sit there. They're going to stomp us in the ground. They're going to moonwalk on top of us. Then they're going to take their zipper down and take a pee-pee on top of us. And then we're just not. And then we're going to lose to a freaking Sun Belt team. A Fun Belt team at home in Willie B. I'm calling it the Gamecocks lose to the Fun Belt in 2 weeks by at least 2 scores. 2 weeks by 2 scores. Hey, nobody thought y'all would have beat UGA. You know what? I would have rather lost to Georgia by 3 points than beat this crappy team. I mean, I really would. It's just Jekyll and Hyde. It's Jekyll and Hyde. I mean, you don't know what's going to happen. I would rather lose to the teams we're supposed to lose to and beat the damn teams we're supposed to. These guys are garbage. Somebody said you're going full potato. No, I'm not. That was a fluke. Oh, it was a fluke. It was a fluke that Jake Fromm threw 3 interceptions that we forced him into. It was a fluke that we stopped their running game. It was a fluke that Rodrigo Blankenship did this and that. Beep, 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 beep. It wasn't a fluke. It was the fact we were the better team on that day, jerky. Fucking asshole. I can't stand the stupid ass shit. It was a fluke. It was a fluky fluke. It wasn't a fluke. They don't get points for flukes, dumbass. Nah, y'all are so goddamn stupid who say that. We were the better team. We beat them. We're better than Tennessee. We should have beat their ass today, but we can't do it. Don't have a heart attack. Well, I might just dang do it. I mean, retired our Garmin Gator fan. Is this not worth having a heart attack against? How much y'all beat them by? 50 points? They're terrible. They're terrible. They are horrible. Don't blow a gasket. Shut up. Don't tell me how to get upset. Shut up. Once again, Ryan Nolinsky still in there taking sacks. Woo! Like a champ. Where's Dak Joyner at? He's still missing. Still on the back of that milk carton, brother. Tennessee just the better team today. Well, I guess they are. They deserve it to be the better team once in about 3 or 4 years. The offensive line doesn't have a presence. They're terrible. They're absolutely terrible. Daniel Batuli, he blocks a punt. He returns it for a touchdown. He gets 5 sacks. You know, somebody don't, you know. Somebody say, I love watching you. He must be a Clemson Tiger fan. Luke Doty's coming. Yeah. I hope he's coming to something better. I hope he's coming to something better. He's coming to a better coaching staff. Ryan sucks. Yeah, well, I'm going to go and agree with you. He does. I mean, this is great. And, I mean, like I said, he's a great kid, and I like him. I like his story and his family, and I like why he's here, and I like what he brings to the energy that they bring, but he's just not ready yet. He's just not. That game against Alabama, it was a damn farce. It was a damn farce. There he goes. Sacked again. Sacked again. This is becoming laughable. It is becoming comical and laughable. It was like last year when they played Kentucky. This shitty ass damn Tennessee team lost to Kentucky last year when Kentucky was clearly the better team. And we're doing it this year. We're clearly a better team than they are, but for some reason, we're losing, and they're kicking our ass. I mean, it's not even close. It's not even close. This is embarrassing. We're going for it on 4th and 17 with a shitty quarterback who hadn't done jack shit. He's running around. He's tucking it, and then he takes a loss. So a flag. Now he's hurt. Looks like, I don't know. It's a holding call, which Tennessee declines, and they're going to get the ball back, and Will Muschamp over there clapping like a madman. Yeah, we're on a little bit more. God damn it, we're going to win this thing. You are a stupid-ass idiot. Hey, yeah, I done told y'all my feelings on him. He was a damn moron, and nobody believed me. So we're down by 20. Let's see what we do here. We've got the shitty quarterback Garantano back in there again. Let's see what he's going to do. Now, this is Jennings. Let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4. Oh, damn. Our defense made a stand. We stood him up. My God, we planted him on his butt after a one-yard gain. And we're going to get physical. And T.J. Brunson going to try to get in a fight with him. Too bad we're only down by 20 points, T.J. Too bad we're only down by 20 points, T.J. Let's get all mad about it. What's that going to do to solve anything? That's what I don't understand about these players. We get down by 20 points. We're going to start throwing fisticuffs. I don't know what he is. Retired Army Gator fan. I don't know if it's him or it's the players. I think it's a combination of the two. You know, I think it's a combination of the players that he's recruited and just a goddamn culture problem. Number 8 takes it over the 50-yard line, picks up another first down for Tennessee. It's a first down. Tennessee Vols. Good Lord, look at that juggernaut of a football program. Oh, my Lord, y'all. This is sad. I mean, it's sad when... Oh, Lordy mercy. Have you ever heard about something talking about so daggone bad, you kind of laugh to keep from crying? That's what I think about this. Said he had his best team. Well, retired Army Gator fan, that dude has been... He was your coach at one time, wasn't he? So, guess what? Ain't he been proven to be a liar? I mean, is y'all not proven to be a liar, too? I mean, he's been proven to be a liar. He lies about everything with South Carolina. He lies about injuries. He lies about, you know, depth. He lies about this. He lies about that. He's just an overall piece of shit. And I can't wait till he's gone. I can't wait till this whole damn staff is gone. Because they suck. I don't care that he beat Georgia. It was a damn upset. Whoop-dee-freaking-do. I don't care. I don't care. I can't wait till he's gone. I don't. Good Lord. Lord, I mean...
Y'all beat UGA with third string quarterback, and now no, it was a second string quarterback. Anybody think that Tennessee's offensive coordinator, Jim Fat Ass Cheney, looks like Jim Ross from the damn WWE? Oh, good old JR. His old gold slobber knocker. That's a slobber knocker or Stone Cold. I'm about ready to I don't know. God help us. God help me. You know, sometimes I pray. I'm like, Lord, I mean, why did you give me, I don't know. I mean, it's bad to say it, but I mean, sometimes I wonder and I ask the Lord, why did he give me this team to pull for and to not be able to stop pulling for him? I don't understand it. I don't understand it sometimes. I mean, I'm not trying to be funny or sacrilegious or ugly, but I mean, I wonder that. I mean, why are some of us saddled with that? I mean, we can't stop. I mean, it's not just like I'm going to say, all right, I'm done. I'm cheering for Clemson now. Or, all right, I'm done. I'm pulling for Ohio State now, not y'all. I mean, we just can't stop. We can't stop doing it. We can't stop giving up hope. I mean, but, I mean, right now, this is bad. This is a horrible football team that y'all are losing to. You got a guy over here on the sideline right now who has his dookie locks pulled up and painted gold. That's who you're losing to. Just a shitty football team. And guess what? You're an even shittier football team than them. Oh, boy, Gamecocks got the ball back with 5 minutes left. How long will it take us to get sacked and punt the ball here? I'm waiting on it because I know their game's starting soon. I'm waiting on somebody to tell me, hey, Jackpot, guess what? Clemson's up 7-0. Woo! Trevor Lawrence. Woo! Woo! Freaking fuck stick. Probably beat us by 100 points this year. Holinsky drops back. We look, and Nick Muse takes it for a first down. All right. We move it up to the 20. Good job, Nick. Too bad we only got 5 minutes left to play in the game, and we're up down by too much. Wish y'all had Trevor right about now. No, I really don't wish we had Trevor. I wish we had some wide receivers also that could make plays, but thank you. I really don't wish that we had Trevor right now, because guess what our quarterback hadn't done today? Throw some interceptions. Guess what? I bet you Trevor will do today. Throw some interceptions against Boston College. In fact, I just about guarantee it. I'll guarantee it. I'll bet with you right now, sir. I'll give you an internet handshake that Trevor will throw an interception against Boston College. And that Ryan Holinsky will not throw any interceptions against Tennessee. I'm almost all the way to my goal. What about you? You want Jake Fromm. Yeah, Jake Fromm. He's a juggernaut, ain't he? How'd y'all beat Georgia? Jason Farmer says with laughing faces. Because Georgia sucks, that's why. And obviously they suck worse than our shitty team does. Holding on, South Carolina. What a shock. You can have Franks from Florida. No thanks. No thanks on Franks. He can throw all the interceptions he wants as long as we win. Yeah. I want to tell you what. playing that sorry soft schedule y'all do and just barely squeaking by against some of these horrible teams, it's going to come back to bite you in the ass eventually. You're not going to progress in the college football playoff. I'm going to tell you right now, Ohio State, I'm calling it right now that they're winning a national championship. They're better than anybody else out there. I mean, it's just, I mean, they just are. And I'm not going full potato on that. I mean, it's obvious. They proved it today. Beyond the shadow of a doubt. Clemson, you fans, you sit here, you can talk all the shit you want to. You can tell me all this shit about Travis Etienne, all this shit about Xavier Thomas, all this shit about goddamn Trevor Lawrence and how great they are. The bottom line is, if y'all play Ohio State, they will kick your ass. Bottom line, they kick anybody's ass. I mean, they're just really that good. It's just, oh, well, we're just laying in wait. We're just laying in wait. Well, you can lay in wait only so long. Somebody said, didn't you say that last year? Yes, I did. And I'm going to tell you what. And this is why everybody makes fun of you and talks about the SEC schedule and this and that. Because you play nobody all year long. You don't get the injuries that all these other teams do. You don't get banged up like all these other teams do. You sit here and you play these terrible shit show teams from your crappy little conference all year long. Then you get to the playoffs and you're able to run through in the first round. It's a crappy little team like Notre Dame. And then you played Alabama. You were able to luck out and catch them. They're probably still be up and sore. I mean, they played an actual schedule last year. You didn't play a schedule. You played a bunch of high school teams. You know it's true, and you want to sit here and laugh about it, and you wonder why everybody makes fun of you. They make fun of you because it's true, and you want to sit here, that's not true. It ain't. It is true. It's 110% true. That somebody said the ACC is garbage. They are. They are. They're absolutely a shit show. And just for the record, we lost to a couple of them. I'm not saying that we're not an absolute shit show either. We are an absolute hell on wheels show. We're horrible. Right now, we're actually moving the ball down the field against Tennessee because they're going to them prevent shit. Nick Muse. Oh, Nick. Nicky, baby. Catching a couple. Thanks for the damn drops a couple of series ago that really cost us. But, hey, thank you for this. You know, we might get within one touchdown of the Vols. Thank you, Tavian Fisher, there for dropping that pass. That was wide open. How the hell... I mean, somebody had to put down Crisco on that damn ball for you to drop that. That's the only explanation I have for that. That was terrible. Well, there's old Will Muschamp putting his hand on his hip on the sideline. You know, he dresses like Joe Morrison, my favorite coach of all time from South Carolina. 1984, Black Magic. Seems like Will Muschamp's trying to go back to Black Magic with the Carolina script stuff on his helmet and right here. Motherfucker, you ain't got one-tenth of his damn heart. You ain't got one-tenth of his coaching ability. You ain't got one-tenth of his team. If you wrestled Joe Morrison, it would be a handicap match. It would only be a handicap match because Joe Morrison's just that much more of a man than what you are. He ain't worth a crap. I'm done with him. I'm done with... Done with every one of them. Can we get this thing over with? Let's just get it over with. I mean, just why are we delaying this, the damn idiocy? Just get it over with. If Failure to get another first down. Y'all ain't worth a shit. All right, guys. I'm done here. I mean, somebody said, I feel your pain. I'm sure you do. Everybody's team's been through this at one point or another. Just losing to an abysmal, shitty team. Yeah, I just, when I look at Jeremy Pruitt, I just want to walk over there. I just want to walk up to what is that? I just want to go up to Knoxville, Tennessee right now, just kick him in the gut and give him a stone cold stunner. Because he is just that stupid looking of a head coach. He won't be there in a couple of years. After he loses, mark my words, this will be that bald-headed